The first thing you need for a NUAGE installation is a standard gigabit Ethernet switch. All of the audio interfaces, the workstation, and the control surfaces are all going to connect via Ethernet into this 1 gigabit switch. And that's how all the control data and audio signals are routed in the entire system. Please make sure there are no VLANs programmed for any of the ports you want to use on the switch. This will interfere with NUAGE. Then start by installing the Dante accelerator card into your primary workstation. Now the workstation actually requires 2 connections to the gigabit switch. The first connection is from the Dante card for all of the audio signals, and the second connection is to the normal Ethernet port on the computer to communicate between the control surfaces and Nuendo. Next, connect each device in your NUAGE system to the gigabit switch. This includes each hardware control surface and each audio interface, along with 2 connections to each workstation. On the back of each audio interface in your NUAGE system, there is a rotary switch, and this switch is used to create a unique identifier that both the NUAGE workgroup manager and the Dante controller use to identify the audio interface. So what you want to do is set the IDs in the order in which you want to see the audio interfaces presented in both the workgroup manager and the Dante controller. You can have up to 8 audio interfaces in your NUAGE system. Next, install Nuendo 6, tools for NUAGE, and the Dante controller onto your workstation. At this point, you can turn on all the devices in your system, and they'll be self-discovered by the workgroup manager. If you're on a PC, you will also have to install Bonjour Print Services and QuickTime Player from Apple. Now let's go ahead and open the Dante controller. And in here, you can connect all of the inputs and outputs of the NUAGE system between the audio interfaces and the workstation. But first, let's take a look at the clock status tab. Right now, we can see the 2 devices in the system, the accelerator card here, and the Neo 8x8 interface. And the clock status shows that the PCIe card is the clock master right now, and the Neo interface is the slave. If we want to change that, we can go over here to the clock roll and change the preferred master from the Dante card to the Neo interface. And now you can see the clock status changes, and the Neo interface becomes the master. And what this allows us to do is to use an external word clock. Say if we were synchronizing using a Steinberg sync station, we'd need to be able to use the external word clock input on the Neo interface to clock the entire system to the sync station. So let's go back to the routing tab. Now what you see on top here are all of the Dante transmitters. And basically the transmitters are all the outputs from the various devices in the Dante network. The first unit here is the Dante accelerator card, which has 128 outputs available. Then over here on the left, we have the Dante receivers. And the receivers are all the inputs to the various devices on the network. The first device is the accelerator card, which has 128 inputs. And then the next one is the Neo 8x8 interface, and which has 16 inputs on it. Now, the way you would route one of the outputs from the Dante accelerator card to the Neo interface is by clicking over here in this routing box. And in a second, you'll have your signal routed to that channel. Now, if you want to do all 16 at once in a linear fashion, you can use the control key and click in this upper corner here, and it will immediately route all 16 channels directly from the PCI card to the Neo interface. Now, in order to route all of the inputs back into Nuendo, we have to go in the opposite direction. So what I can do here is close up the tabs for the receivers in the interface, and open up the tab for the Dante accelerator card receivers, and go up here to the transmitters, close up the PCIe card, and open up the Neo interface. Now I can use the same methodology by using the control key to route all 16 of the Neo interface inputs all the way to the Dante accelerator card inputs. But it's interesting to note that Dante is far more flexible than this. For example, we can have this Dante transmitter from the Neo interface go to more than 1 input on the Dante accelerator card in the workstation. And this allows for all types of interesting routing schemes you can come up with. For example, here, I'm just routing a few more of the inputs into the Neo interface to additional inputs on the PCI card. There is a limit to how many different connections you can make under unicast. For one NUAGE system operating in unicast, you are limited to 128 individual audio connections within the system. Now when you open up the Workgroup Manager, it should look something like this. All the hardware devices on the network will show up in this lower window, and then we can add them one by one into our workgroup. But first, before we do that, we need to identify which fader unit is first on the left here, because the order in which we add them is important. So we can use these buttons here to identify each unit in the system. When we press this button on the master unit, we can see the knobs start to flash to identify that this is the unit we're talking about. Then when I flash this one, we know that that's the leftmost fader unit. Now, the order in which you add the fader units matters, so we want to start with the leftmost fader unit in the system and add that first. Then we can add the next fader unit, which is this one, then the master unit, and then finally the Neo interface. Now, they all come up into this work group, and now they're part of this NUAGE system. If there was additional hardware units within the network, they could be used to configure another NUAGE system on a different workstation. Now all we're missing is the Nuendo DAW itself. In order to have it be available in the device list, it needs to be running. So start Nuendo. Once Nuendo has booted up, it should become available in the Workgroup Manager device list, like this. And then we can add it to our workgroup. And now we have a complete NUAGE system. Next, you'll need to configure the display behind each fader unit. Since the display is connected to your workstation on one of the monitor outputs, you need to tell NUAGE which one of those outputs is connected to the display behind that fader unit. And the way you do this is by using all three of the modifier keys on the left side of the fader unit together. When you press them all at the same time, the section control buttons on the top right of the fader unit light up. The brightly lit one indicates which display output is currently chosen as the one that's behind the fader unit. But if you don't see a mixer window behind there, it's the wrong display. So basically, you can press through until you find the correct number that brings a mixer to this fader unit. And the way to tell which, if it's correct or not, is by selecting a channel, and you'll see the gray outline above that fader unit that corresponds to your selected channel. Now you need to fine-tune the size of the NUAGE mix console in the monitor to match the actual size of the fader unit itself. Since different 24-inch monitors might have a slightly different size, that's why we include this calibration. So again, press all three modifier keys on the left side of the fader unit, and now you have three controls on the knob set above that help you configure the actual size of the mix console. If you line up the right edge using this knob, you can bring that edge in to the very edge of the mixer, and then do the same for the left side until everything is precisely aligned. And that just helps align the display on the screen with the channel on the fader unit itself. And then finally, the center knob will control the height of the meters, depending on how you like to see them. The NUAGE system relies on the software control room facilities within Nuendo. When you first boot up Nuendo, control room is turned off by default. In order to access it, go to the devices menu and go to VST connections. Here is where you make all the audio connections in and out of the Nuendo software. The last tab is called the Studio tab, and here is where you can enable control room with this button right here. Now, when you first turn on control room, there are no channels available in it at all. You have to configure it as your studio requires. You basically can think of the control room mixer as a secondary mixer within Nuendo that has its own set of inputs and its own set of outputs. The inputs are all the various monitor sources. They can be stem tracks, external inputs, the actual mix bus itself. And the outputs can be speaker systems within the studio. They could be headphone cue systems, that sort of thing. So let's take a look. The first thing I'm going to do is add a monitor, which is basically a speaker system. And in this case, you can configure the channel width however you require. There's all sorts of possibilities here depending on the speaker system in your studio. We'll use 5.1, and you can label it 5.1 speaker. Now, once it's created, you actually have to assign physical outputs for those speaker channels to be connected to your speaker system in the studio. In this case, we'll use the first 8 channels of the Dante accelerator card, which are routed to the Neo interface to connect to our speakers. Next, we can add a Q channel. And a Q channel was used to feed a headphone system in the studio for talent to use when they're recording. You can add up to 4 stereo cues in the control room. Once again, you'll have to assign them physical outputs before you connect them to the headphone system. Next, there's an actual headphone output, which is used to feed the headphone amp that's built into the Nuage master unit. It's independent of the cues. Again, you have to connect it to a physical output. And then you'll have to take that physical output, the analog output, and connect it to the stereo inputs on the back of the master unit. Now, in order to communicate with people in the studio recording, you'll need a talkback channel. The talkback channel has to be connected to a physical input. Now, the master unit of the Nuage system has a built-in talkback mic with its own preamp. So all you need to do is take the output of that from the back of the master unit and feed it into an analog input on the Neo interface and route that to the same channel in control room. We can add an external input. Let's say, for example, you have a DVD player in the studio that you use to reference to. You can configure an external input that is connected to that DVD player. Let's say it's in 5.1 as well. Now we assign physical inputs to that control room channel. And now it's possible using the dedicated hardware buttons on the master unit to switch to that external input and hear the DVD or the same speaker system that you're mixing on in the studio. And finally, there are the monitor sources. Now, monitor sources in the control room can come from any input, any output, and any of the summing buses within the Nuendo mixer itself. So for example, over here under the group submenu, we have all the stem tracks, which are the summing buses in this particular mix. These change depending on which project is active at that point in time. So I'm going to add all the stem tracks as monitor sources. Now I can easily switch between dialogue, Foley, ambience, effects, and music just on the dedicated buttons up here in the control room section of the master unit. Now let's access the DSP-based speaker management system in the NIO interface. Go to the Devices menu and choose the Nuage IO setup. Now here we can see controls for bass management, but they're not active or available. And the reason for that is currently we're selected on the first monitor, which is just for the NS10s, and it's only in stereo. There's no bass management available for that. If we go to the B monitor, which is a 5.1 system, now the controls become active. In order to turn on bass management, you turn it on here. Now you have all control over the filters and the gain settings for the surround system. Next, we can look at the attenuation and delay tab. For each of the speaker systems, you can adjust the level and delay for each channel in order to align the speaker system in your studio. There are some additional setup features on the Nuage master unit that affect the hardware controllers. If you go to the setup page on the touchscreen, on the top row, we have controls that affect the sensitivity of all the different controls in the hardware unit. Over here, there are brightness controls for the different displays. On the lower part, there are preferences that affect how the faders operate. We can turn the motors on and off. We can turn the channel auto select on, so when you touch a channel, that becomes selected. There's also the display mode, which determines how large the text is on the OLED displays for each channel. Then there are some timers for the displays, SPL calibration for the control room, and the direction of the numeric pad key entry.